Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Let's Play Cabela's Legendary Adventures. Last time we got Denali, the legendary caribou, and this time I think we're going after an elk? No, it was a pronghorn. Yeah, it was a pronghorn. Hang on. I'm getting there. There we go. Now, that should be better. Yep. Alright. I'm just trying to make sure I got everything that. Let's go. That's good. No. Alright. I think we're good with everything, so let's begin.
He was in his 40s, he got the itch for a speed goat, also known as a pronghorn antelope. So he did some research, came up with a short list of potential hunting locations, and finally narrowed it down to Catrone County, New Mexico, which had a tremendous reputation for record book antelope. As an added bonus, Victor had never been to that part of the world, and just like every other member of my family, he was always eager to head out for parts unknown. So he packed his SUV and hit the road in September of 1985. When he finally arrived, it was so isolated, he felt like he'd driven to the ends of the planet. We're talking about a county that's bigger than three eastern states, with a population of less than 4,000 residents. Take a cross-country hike and you're more likely to see a coyote, desert mule deer, pintailed duck, or Rio Grande turkey than a person. Victor grabbed a room at a roadside motel for the night, double-checked his .243 bolt-action rifle, an all-around workhorse that shoots groups as tight as I've ever seen. Then he set his alarm for 5 o'clock the next morning.
Okay. All right, here we go. Oh, that's a good size mule deer. Oh, there's a skull. What do you got? It's a bow. Alright. Did see that builder. One. Oh, wait. Oh, okay, it doesn't have to be a buck. Slow down. Damn. Oh, there's another skull there. The most dignified shot, I know, but that's nothing. There we go. Oh, there we go. Okay, yeah, two for the handgun. Alright. Let's go ahead. Oh, I think I saw this one. Where's that one? I know I saw another one. I just gotta find him. Bingo. It's another female, but it'll work. Okay. Got her. Alright. I think we can move on. Oh, 11 minutes or something. Let's do mission 4. Wait, already?
Victor always said it was beginner's luck, but he managed to find a record book pronghorn buck. Both horns measured over 17 inches.
I didn't even make it to the next area. Where is he? I don't see him. Where is he? Wait, is that him? I didn't even make it to the next area. Oh, there he is. Okay, that was quick. Damn.
Final score was 89 3/8. Not only was it a fine-looking symbol of the American West, it would look great hanging on his wall.
Well, yeah, bronze, because I didn't really do a whole lot of hunting. But, I mean, I was not expecting to get him that quick. I was thinking maybe go to the next area, do a couple more missions, and then he'll pop up, but no. I didn't even get to leave the area. Jeez. That was quick. That was extremely quick. Dear Lord. Alright, so Theo, the Roosevelt Elk, is our next hunt, so, okay. So yeah, he was a quick find. I was not expecting to find him that quick. I didn't even leave the area. So yeah, that's gonna be it for today's video. I hope you all enjoyed this. If you did, hit that like button, subscribe to, if you're new to the channel, want to support the channel, and hit that notification bell so you guys never miss another video. I guess next up is Theo the Roosevelt Elk, and I will see you all next time. Bye bye.